Nissan X TRAIL 2004 with a C's 2.2D engine was dropped off at a vehicle repair facility. The vehicle mileage was in excess of 260,000 kilometers, so the decision was made to replace the engine with a used engine having a mileage of about 180,000 kilometers. The used replacement engine was missing the fuel system and a camshaft sensor. A technician replaced the engine. The fuel supply system and the camshaft sensor were moved from the original engine to the replacement. No other replacements were made. After everything was assembled, it was time to test. Start the engine. But, unfortunately, the engine did not start, so a scan tool was used to look for trouble codes. However, there were no error codes stored. The fuel pressure in the fuel rail during cranking was from 180 to 200 bar. Which is normal for this engine. We started looking for the cause of the engine not starting using a USB Autoscope 4 automotive oscilloscope, since there were no trouble codes to guide us. Using the oscilloscope, we tested the main electrical signals of the engine control system. From the crankshaft and camshaft sensors, as well as the injector control on one of the cylinders. The crankshaft and camshaft sensor signals were present, but there were no fuel injector control. Most often, this situation is caused by the engine control unit being unable to recognize the signals from the crankshaft or camshaft speed sensors. A lack of fuel pressure will not cause a lack of injector control. Most likely, there is a problem with the signals from the crankshaft or camshaft sensors. We proceeded with comparing the signals we recorded with a known good or reference waveform. On the forum of the website injectorservice.com.ua, there is a database of reference signals from various vehicles, provided by users of the USB Autoscope 4 devices. Link to the signal is in video description. Comparing the reference signals with those we recorded. It is clear that on our replacement engine, the pulses from the camshaft sensor arrive earlier than on the reference waveform. There can only be one reason for this. The incorrect location of the camshaft sensor timing wheel or disc relative to the crankshaft sensor timing wheel or disc. Given this, we again carefully checked the timing or installation marks of the engine timing chain, cam, and crank. Everything lined up correctly. So, why would the teeth of the camshaft sensor wheel or disc align with the camshaft sensor earlier than expected? We found relevant information searching the internet. It turns out that the YD22ETI engine can be equipped with two different types of crankshaft and camshaft sensors, either Hall effect or VRS. The timing wheel or disc for the camshaft sensor is different for the two sensor types. On this engine, the camshaft sensor wheel or disc is combined with the timing chain gear and has one tooth or pin for each cylinder with a double tooth for cylinder number one. The 13024AW400 timing chain gear was installed on engines equipped with a Hall sensor, and the 13024AD200 was installed on engines with an inductive camshaft sensor. Luckily, we had the timing chain gear from the seized engine designed to work with a Hall effect camshaft sensor. A visual comparison of the two gears reveal a small but very important difference. The teeth of the camshaft sensor pins are offset relative to the drive gear by two chain teeth. We disassemble the replacement engine sufficiently to install the camshaft timing chain gear from the original engine. After reassembly, the engine started and ran perfectly. We record the signals from the crankshaft and camshaft sensors again and compare them with the known good reference waveform. There is a slight but noticeable difference in the timing of the sensor signals from the reference recording and from our recording. This is due to the stretching of the drive chain, which is to be expected after over 180,000 kilometers. The customer decided to hold off on replacing the timing chain for now.